Hello again. This is our market update for January 20th, 2010. People ask me all the time what's going on in the market, and I think if I had to sum up in two words what I think is happening in the market, I would say excitement and frustration. Sellers are excited to hear sales are up and inventory is down. Both of these things are positives for sellers. And yet at the same time, those same sellers are frustrated to hear prices aren't heading north yet. Now, buyers are excited to see great deals out there in foreclosures and in short sales, but they also learn that those come with hassles, bidding wars, and extra costs. Right now in the market, we're seeing a buzz in the air. We're seeing a lot of activity, and I don't think it's just tied into the home buyer credits that are due to expire in a couple months. As we've said before, we're not going to know when we've turned the corner on this market with prices going up again until months after it's happened. But there are some real positives in the most recent sales statistics that we've seen here in the county. The average sale price in December 2009 was over $10,000 higher than a year ago. And there are 37% fewer homes on the market than in December of 2008. Total sales are up nearly 30%. And time supply of inventory is down to 8 months from over 14 months a year ago. Now, with the optimism comes the continued challenging news of the non-traditional sales. Although bank-owned sales were down 12% in December from a year ago, we are seeing many bank and government homes coming onto the market right now. Now, this increase in non-traditional listings isn't a surprise to us here at Buckley Jolley. We've been predicting it for about 6 months now. Although not a science, we have been using a foreclosure forecasting system for the past 2.5 years now. We tracked a number of foreclosure notices in the Livingston County Daily Press and Argus and use a weekly average to determine trends. As you can see, foreclosure notices in the paper were highest in the first 6 months of 2009. With the timing of the foreclosure process, the notice, a sheriff's sale, and the redemption period, a home will most likely come on the market 10 to 14 months after the notice. So, right now we're entering into a time when those homes that were in the newspaper about a year ago will be coming on the market. They will outnumber the current inventory of foreclosures. In looking at this, we can only hope that the demand increases as the supply also increases. As you know, foreclosures and short sales tend to push values down, and each sale then becomes a low mark for future appraisals. Unfortunately, appraisers cannot ignore those low sales when they are completing appraisals on traditional sales. So we're in a time of transition where bank-owned properties are selling very quickly for over asking price after multiple offers, and yet values have not quite stabilized. Strange but true. As reported last month, short sales continue to increase, up 126% from a year ago. Short sales are represented by the green line on this graph. For reference, the total sales are purple and at the top. Traditional sales are represented in red, and bank-owned sales are shown on the blue line. With that said, a number of buyers have decided to stay away from short sales and foreclosures. They feel there are great deals out there that are traditional sales, and we agree. We listed a home last Thursday that had 3 showings over the weekend, and one of those showings led to an offer. We're negotiating that sale right now. A home priced right, marketed effectively, and communicated correctly will attract buyers and will sell. We will continue to study the market and keep you informed. Our goal is for you to experience the excitement without the frustration. Karen Jolley, our team, and I hope this buzz in the market continues. And as always, we welcome your questions. It's going to be a great 2010.